way talk right now. Get shot on the rude-way ting, on the rude-way ting right now. We don't swing. You get shot, you get shot.
What's going on?
Well done, A-Star. Long time, my brother.
I think nine, really.
Yeah, you're done, though. Done, though. Long time. Long time. What's good?
What's going on? You tell the people what's good, like, what's going on right now?
Well, obviously, sure, a lot of people know it's 10th of May today. Keep trains up. You know what I'm saying? All independent record shops. HMV.com, UptownRecords.com, UKRecordShop.com. Yeah, it's a bargain, $7.99. Make sure you go pick that up.
So yeah. You got featured on there?
Got quite a few features on there, but tell you the truth, I tried to keep it more in-house. But I got Jamie, Nasty Jack. There's production from Bless Beats. Obviously, I got fucking Bloodline fam, it's only standard. But I'm saying, but it's more like when you look at the track list and you see it's more of me on a solo tip store, because I'm trying to get respect for myself as an artist. You know what I mean? I can probably get the whole scene on a feature if I wanted to. But I got a lot to say on tunes, innit? So I'm trying to get it out, you know what I'm saying?
There's been a lot of hype and controversy around the Bloodline with the whole Road Deep, Killer P situation. What do you want to say to the fans about that?
What is there to say, really, though, innit? I see my man's got an interview or something. I see the interview. You get me? Obviously, he's talking a bit recklessly about everyone in Bloodline, innit? So, like he said, man needs to do that. He needs to do his research, innit? Real talk, you know what I'm saying? Old type Big H anyway, man, because, you know what I'm saying? He's the pool bearer of this crime shit. Burying certain MCs. You get me? Killer P, man. I heard his bars as well, man. He made 7 tunes for Hates and Hates ain't replied, blood. Why is he going to then go do an interview for, blood? Does it make sense?
Now, what are you to describe your new album? And let the people know what's your new album called that's dropped.
It's a mixtape, you know, cuz. That's what I'm saying. People mix the album, it's not album, it's a mixtape, cuz. That's what I'm saying, cuz. It's a mixtape, right, blood. You can't say if I. But my mixtapes look like albums, though. You get me? Even Pray For Me, that was my first mixtape, innit? My first solo shit, yeah? And, that looks like an album, innit? A lot of people thought that was an album, innit? But that was just a mixtape, bro. You know what I'm saying? Best way to describe it, I'd call it something epic, bro. It's a classic. It's not something you're just gonna pump just because your brethren's there. Not something you're gonna listen to for a week or so and then put behind the rest of the CDs. That's something that you're always gonna be, it's probably gonna always be in your CD player, especially if you're whipping something deep for the car, man. Trust me, man.
How do you think this mixtape is different from your first one?
Obviously, I'm matured. Yeah, flipping them. I think I've kind of found my style a bit better. You'll see that anyway. I just think I just matured genuinely, innit? My mentality, my flows and shit. You can hear, man. I'm starting to, I'm saying, play around with flows and stuff a bit more. Get me?
Alright, so what influenced you growing up listening to grime? What MCs would you say influenced you?
Grime?
Yeah.
I'd say DEE, Big H, Standard D, Bossman, Fizz T. Obviously, them and there, not DEE. DEE is just, he's just fucking good at what he does, innit? Right. Get me? Hold tight, double. But, obviously, H, Prez, Verdi, them are all the cousins, innit? So, I'm naturally going to pick up from what they're saying anyway, but I don't know, I thought they've been a big influence for everyone in North London, not just myself. You get what I'm saying?
Finally, I think, personally, this is what I think, that you and Fair Pablo should do a mixtape back to back. Because I kind of feel that you two got a kind of chemistry and energy going together. So I think you two should do a mixtape back to back.
Is that what you think, yeah?
That's what I think.
Swear down.
I swear down.
What, you're not just saying that?
Nah, fam, I think it should be done. I think the fans want to see it as well. Fair Pablo, 9 Milli, back
to back. You're not. The fans, you just might get that. You know what I'm saying? I don't really want to talk too much, but, yeah, me and Pablo, we've been talking. We've been talking about doing a joint venture, joint CD together. But obviously, if you do that, it's got to be fucking mad. Mad, fuck, mad. Because our solo projects are crazy, innit? So if we're doing a joint project, it's got to be mad. But there is something in the pipeline. I don't even want to give away the name right now because it's a bit... You know what I'm saying? It's not, you understand? When everything's a bit more in progress and everything's in clockwork a bit more, then get me. I'll give you a name for it and give out dates and shit. Get me back. But we're definitely working on something.
Alright, that's it.
So a lot of people want to see that stuff.
Wait, 9 Milli Major, Bloodline done though. Tell the people one more time what mixtape you got coming out right about now.
Yeah, keep praying, that's out right now. Make sure you go cop that. Yeah? Make sure you look out for Fire and Smoke. Pay Pablo Money Talks out right now. But yeah, keep praying in UKRecordShop.com and www.uptownrecords.com. get me, like, obviously, yeah, like, I feel flattered, really. Like, get me? He asked me not to write no bars for him. And flipping, I still marked it, blood. You get what I'm saying? So, like, I just feel flattered over the whole situation. Like, get me? Don't get me wrong. Like, it was a good thing, like, me going up against Sharky and all that. But, get me? It's good promotion for both of us, innit? But really, like, you can't deny it. I helped him out a bit, bro. I'm saying that, like, because he weren't really doing shit. I mean, obviously, I put him onto this mic fight thing. Like, flipping, we both gone there, like, he's a snake, man, innit? What he tried to do is end my career, innit? But he can't do that, bro. He's not good enough. You know, he's not good enough to end my career, bro. Never that. Get me, flipping. But what do you think about the whole thing, though? How do you think it went down?
I think it went down good, because, like I said, Sharky Major's been in the game from day dot, doing last degree. Get me?
Day dot. Do you know what I didn't like, though, yeah? Like, see the vibe here that I come there on, yeah? I come there on, like, a bridging thing, you know? Like, I'm not a dickhead, you know, fam? But I come there on the thing where, like, yeah, me and Sharky are cool. Like, you'll see, like, I'm all there saying, yeah, we're both good artists. Shit like that. You know what I'm saying? People just come there, like, saying, oh, I'm the only major and shit like that. You know what I'm saying? Like, I just thought that was a bit of a disrespect. You know what I'm saying? Like, obviously, he's come to me on a bridging thing, innit? It's not like that. If I'd have come there on that vibe, bruv, he wouldn't have even wanted to pick up the mic, bruv. You know what I'm saying? Because I'd just been going on a rude boy thing, bruv. It's not just a tune, bruv. You know what I'm saying? Like, I can be that guy if you want me to, bruv. You know what I'm saying? I'm a blessed brother. Don't get it twisted, as most of them know, but, bruv, like, seriously, bruv, like, I'm not gonna ask me not to write no bars for him and he writes bars, but anyway, yeah, man still worked it anyway. You know what I'm saying? It's all good promotion, whole tight risky road. You know what I'm saying? He put together a good set.